angels we have heard on high has kind of an interesting history. It was originally written for band and choir, double choirs, about 120 people. It was written for the finale of a university Vesper program, so it had to be exciting. They didn't give me a lot of time to write it, so I wrote the choral parts first, since they have to be memorized. But then I had to go on orchestra tour, and I had to write all of the band parts on the bus. And as soon as we got back from the tour, I had some wonderful students who helped me copy the parts, and the band played it one day later, and then played it that same week on the program. So it was just one of those things that there aren't many pieces written for band and choir, so it was an unusual situation. But since that time, it has been transcribed for orchestra. That's much more practical for most people. And of course, a lot of people just use the piano accompaniment, which tries to capture the excitement that you would find in the band or the orchestra. It's one of the most exciting of all the Christmas carols, partly because of the wonderful words of the stanzas that talk about the birth of Christ and the shepherds and the angels. But then it has that wonderful chorus, Gloria in excelsis Deo, glory to God in the highest, which we get to sing several times, and it gets hopefully more and more glorious each time.